Well, now to the fight against drug addiction in the La Crosse community. New numbers from local health officials say efforts are working. This year, there have been 16 overdose deaths, but last year, that number was 24. And the year before that, it was 29. News 19's Brittany Lake introduces you to an area woman making her very private story public to help others in the throes of addiction find hope.
If you see Nikki Grant today, you'd never guess what she was like just 3 short years ago.
Started a lot like most people with experimenting with painkillers. Once I was introduced to the needle, that's where it all went downhill.
This mom of three lost her house, her job, her car, her kids, all because of drugs.
And I was so busy chasing the drug and chasing money for the drug that I was not spending any time with my children.
Just like she didn't care about anything anymore except getting the drugs.
She was living on the streets.
I didn't know where she was. I didn't know from day to day if she was alive or dead.
She was sitting in jail when she found out that she was pregnant.
And I had hit my rock bottom.
Her family, specifically her mom and sister, were always there for her.
Without us, she had nobody.
Sometimes with the tough love.
I was always the one, call the cops, turn her in.
But that tough love quickly turned into tenderness.
She's my sister, you know. We've always been best friends. Her kids are like my kids, so forgiving her, you know, there was no way around it. We had to forgive to become a family again.
That's a coffee cake.
Nikki got clean and got her family back. Now they get to be a family again, and Nikki is hoping her story saves other families.
If you don't deep down want to get better and leave that life behind, it's just going to be a revolving door.
She's sharing what happened to her in these public service announcements.
My life has changed so much.
She learned to heal and knows that others can too.
Things will change. You just have to work for it, give it time. But never lose hope. Don't lose faith. Things will get better. But know that if you can just work through that thought, life is going to get better than if you choose to go use.
Now you can see Nikki in that public service announcement right here on News 19. It's part of a coordinated community response to the opioid crisis by the Alliance to Heal. So far, it's working.
We definitely have seen reductions in drug-related hospitalizations and ER visits, and in particular to opioids, including heroin. We've seen a reduction in drug overdose deaths. We've seen quite a significant reduction in the toxicology reports of those that have died of an overdose, that the prescription opioids are way down, which is good. So it's still the heroin and the illicit fentanyl that are causing the majority of the drug overdose deaths.
If you or someone you know is fighting addiction and needs help, go to this website, wxow.com/A, 2H.